So thank you, sir, for this opportunity, and hello to all the seniors. We are going to discuss a case about bilateral PDR where laser pan-retinal photocoagulation sound is okay, sir?
Yeah.
Was done initially to stabilize the diabetic retinopathy process. The beginning of the left eye vitrectomy is seen here with clearing of the
increase the volume, Sapnesh.
And the anterior vitrectomy completed. Diabetic vitrectomy also has many challenges in form of vitreous chiasis. So induction of PVD is very tough. You can see a flat tabletop configuration of the posterior high margin.
Yes, volume is less,
which is making the PVD induction absolutely
it's maximum
difficult.
Sir.
Rohit, Sapnesh, you can supplement it with your own dialogues.
Optimization, modern use of
basically a flat tabletop configuration,
the dissection,
vitreous chiasis, those are the difficulties. In spite of using forceps, it was difficult.
I had to resort to use a 24 number needle to create an opening in the posterior hyoid.
I'm using a 24 number needle
because I couldn't
create
get
an opening.
Any cleavage plane using the forceps. You have to be extremely careful at this step and see to it that we are not traumatizing the retina below.
So, with the port optimization, we can go in the cleavage plane, start the dissection. So you have to be careful not to traumatize the retina below.
Of these membranes. Because of the port optimization, desegmentation is quite easy, as you can see. There are multiple areas of fibrovascular proliferation with point attachment. Hence, we have to rotate the mouth of the cutter as well as sometimes use our left hand to proceed with the dissection. Now I am using forceps to loosen the posterior hyoid over the optic nerve head. We have to be extremely careful while doing this procedure because we can induce a lot of bleeding